Hello friends, welcome to the Woolen Artifacts channel. Today in this video we will learn how to make a mini handbag. For this I have taken 4-ply wool and this is the multicolor wool. And I have taken 3.5 mm needle, small thread, small size needle, and then press buttons, scissors. So we will start our project with the knot. You can see my previous videos, how to make knot and how to get clarity on the basic stitches. So I have made this knot. For this I will make 18 rings, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So I have made 18 rings of chain and I have chosen this half double crochet. So we have to leave the first string and we have to make 3 half double crochets in the second ring. Make sure we have 3 layers here. So we use 2 layers and insert the needle. One, two, three. I have made 3 half double crochets. We have to make half double crochets throughout the line. I have finished half double crochet throughout the line and we reached the end. So we have to make 5 half double crochets in this last ring. 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. We have to make half double crochet from the remaining all rings. So this is the second ring. In the first ring we have made 5 half double crochets. So in the second ring we have to make 1 half double crochet in each and every ring. Have finished almost the second side of this line. So this is the last ring and this is the last but one ring and this is the last ring where we made 3 half double crochets. So we will make half double crochet in this second one. We made 5 half double crochets in this end. So in the same way we have to make 5 half double crochets in this end also. We already made 3, so we have to make 2 more in this gap. One, then 2. We have to join this with the slip stitch. This is the first half double crochet which we made. We have to join this with the slip stitch. So this is the first line of the base. Now we will make 1 ring. So here you can see these 5 rings, 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So these 5 rings are the increased rings. So we have to make 2 half half double crochets in this 5 rings. We have started this from the middle ring, so we have to make 2 half double crochets in this one and 2 half double crochets in the next 2 rings. So 2 half double crochets in this 3 rings. In the same way we have to make here in this ring and in this ring. So all 5 rings we have to make 2 half double crochets. In the same way we have to make 2 half double crochets in the 1, 2, 3, 4 and then sorry. Yeah, from here 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So in this 5 half double crochets, we have to make 2 half double crochets. I have came to this end. So these are the 5 half double crochets where we have to make 2 half double crochets. 1, 2, and then this is the second half double crochet. This is the third one. Four. This is the fifth one. So we have made 2 half double crochets in the last 5 half double crochets. Now we have to make 1 half double crochet throughout the line. Except here, so here in these 2 half double crochets we have to make, these are the 2 we already made, 2 half double crochets in 3 rings, so we have to make 2 in these 2 half double crochets. So I will just finish all this line and I will be back. So these are the last 2 rings. We need to make 2 half double crochets here. So we are done. Now we have to join this with the slip stitch. This is the base of our mini handbag. This would be the base. Now in these 2 lines we have increased the corners so that it will not be like shrink or something. So that is, I just increase 2 rings in each and every half double crochet on the edges. Now from this line we no need to increase any ring, so we just join these 2 ends with the slip stitch, make 1 more slip stitch so that this joint will be at the one side middle. Now we have to make 3 rings. So for the remaining the whole project we will use double crochet. That is why I made 3 rings. So this will be considered as 1 double crochet. And we have to make the double crochets in each and every ring. I have completed this first line and I did not increase anywhere. So this is the last ring. We have to make 1 double crochet here. After that we have to join this edge, means ends. This is the 3 rings chain which we made. So we have to make a slip stitch in the third ring. To join these edges. So this will be the base of the bag. Now we want to start our design in this. So till now we just made the half double crochet in this ring. Now I want to make double crochet. We have to just insert the needle. This is the three rings of chain. So I want to just pull the wool in this way from under this and make one single crochet and then two rings. This will be considered as one double crochet. So this is the two rings and this is one single crochet. So we can get three rings here. So three rings, one double crochet. And then next, we have to wrap the wool, put the needle from inside. This is the second ring. So we have to take this second ring in this way and then pull the wool. You can see three rings to this chain. Make one double crochet. So it means we have made one double crochet. Means like to the top of this, and we just made one double crochet in the down. So again we have to make one double crochet in the upside. So we have to wrap the wool and then take the ring, take this double crochet and then make one double crochet. In the same way we have to make, just take the next ring, half the double crochet. This is the manner. And then make one double crochet here. So we have to make double crochets alternatively. One is to the upside and one is to the down. So we have started with the upside one. So whatever the odd number ring double crochet will be there in this line, we can get like upside double crochet, and for the even numbers we will get down double crochet. So for this, to make this design, we have to make one double crochet line first and then we can just start with this design. So in the same manner, so in the second line we made this design, and the next two lines we have to make two double crochet lines, so that one will be the gap and the next double crochet line would be the first line of this design, so that we can start our design again. So I will be back once I just complete the few lines of this bag. Here I have finished few lines. So little bit of length, and we have made first one double crochet line and then we made design like one double crochet down and one double crochet up. So I just completed the first line and I just made one double crochet line, no design, nothing, plain double crochet line. And then we have to make one more double crochet like this, in this way. So after the design, we have to make one double crochet for the gap and one more double crochet line to just start again with our design. So this is the gap and this is the another double crochet line. So we have to make our design in the second double crochet line. So for the upside ring, we have to wrap the wool and then take the double crochet ring and then make one double crochet. And then for the downside, we have to wrap the wool and then take the double crochet from the down and then make double crochet. So in this manner, we have to complete the whole line. So we already came to the end. Last two more rings. So we have finished the line, and this is the starting ring where we made one single crochet and two rings. So that is the starting double crochet which we made upside. So we have to join this last one and the first one. So we have to leave the single crochet and then one ring. So in the second ring we have to make the slip stitch in this way. So now we left with only one line, so that would be the one double, either we can choose double crochet or half double crochet, that is our choice, not a problem. So I just want to take this half double crochet line, so I will finish that line and I will be back to show you how to make the flip and then how to join this press button. I have finished this last line with the half double crochet. So I just completed and we have to make the slip stitch. You have made, and this is the one side and this is the other side. So I want to start the flip from this side. So I just want to make one or two slip stitches. So if you just ended up with here, we have to make 5 slip stitches to reach the this point, because the flip will be from this much length only. So we have to be comfortable to just start our flip. So if you just ended up here, we have to make 4 or 5 slip stitches. So just make 5 slip stitches so that you can reach this point and we can start our flip. So we have to leave, just make it straight and leave 5 rings in each and every side so that we can just make the thread to just hang to our hand. So here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, and I want to make one more slip stitch. So from here to here I will make the flip. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and then 18. So these 18 rings, to these 18 rings I want to make the flip. So I will use the double crochet ring. So I will be back once I just complete the double crochet. 2 to 3 lines and the flip will come till here, not the very length. So it will come like till here only and we can just put the press button here. So I will be back once I just complete it and I will show you how to join the press button. I have finished this first line, so 18 rings. I just wanted to show how to we can knit the second line. So we have to make, once we complete this first line, we have to make 3 rings of chain and then flip our work, make double crochets from the second ring. So this is the first ring, this is the second ring. So this is how we have to just complete, and we completed one line and this is the second line. We may need 2 more lines, so based on the requirement, so how much length you want. If you want till here, then that is fine, we can make 4 or 5 lines, or if you want still more length, you can make 10 lines. So that is up to you. So you can make the length of the flip based on your requirement, and after that I will show you how to just make this handle and then how to join the press button. Here I have made 4 double crochet lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the last one. I just used half double crochet line. So to start your half double crochet, we have to make one ring and then make half double crochets from the starting ring to end. So that is how we have to finish this half double crochet line. And I will just take the wool and then cut it. Now we will start how to make this handle. So here you can see the ring. So I just want to make with this double crochet. So we have to take the 5 rings. 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So we will take these 5 rings in this end and start our handle. For this, we have to make one knot. Make a knot and then just pull the wool from this first ring, pull this extra wool and then make 3 rings here. As I want to start this with the double crochet, so I just made 3 rings. This 3 rings will consider as double crochet, and I want to make 4 more double crochets. So one more double crochet. So 4 double crochets and 3 rings chain. So this will be the 5 double crochets. Now we have to just flip our work with 3 rings and then leave the first ring, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. We have to make double crochets in each and every ring, including the 3 rings chain. So this is the 3 rings chain. We have to make double crochet in the third ring. So in the same way, we have to complete the thread. How much long you want, you can just complete that. And I will be back once I just complete the handle. Here I have completed this handle and I made 76 lines. Now we have to join the other end. Here we have to join for the 5 rings. One, two, three, four, and then 5. Before joining this end, we have to make sure that there is no flips to this thread. It should be plain. So you just insert the needle first to this last ring and then insert it into the first ring of the back and then make a slip stitch. So in the same way, the second ring. So here we are using slip stitches to join the handle and the bag. This is the fourth one, and this is the last ring, last double crochet, that is 3 rings of chain. We have to insert the needle to this third ring and then the fifth ring of this bag. Make a slip stitch, make one ring. So this is how our join will look like. Now you take little bit wool and then cut it. We have to make sure that all the extra threads would be inside. So I have taken the thin needle to just put all the extra holes inside. In this manner, we have to insert the wool so that it will not be visible outside. And then cut this extra wool. Here also we can cut this extra wool. And then this is the edge of this flip. So make sure we are just putting this extra wool inside the flip. Make a knot here. And then put the extra wool inside. And then cut it. So we have finished with this bag. The only part we left with the press button. So this is how we have to join the press button to this bag. I will be back once I just finish it. So here I have joined this press button and I have used white thread and the needle. So based on the length you make this flip and you can just join this press button. So this is the mini handbag for our phones or wallets or anything we can just put inside. And we have finished this project. Hope you enjoyed this project and please like and share my video and subscribe the channel. You can see more videos in my channel and I have pasted the links for a few basic videos and which you can follow and learn more things. Thank you so much.